How old is this school?
The school, Earlscliffe itself, is set up in 2012, but we've been running summer schools since 2001.
Which qualities are required to be a member of the staff?
I would say they have to be have an international spirit, be proactive, be interested in working with young students, have the usual qualities of being fun and sociable and those kind of things.
How do you manage to welcome every student at the airport?
Well, it requires a lot of staff, a lot of organisation, and we have to think about 100 things at once, because we have some students leaving the school at the same time as students arriving. So we have a lot of cleaners in to make sure that the bedrooms are turned around. And then we have a lot of staff at the airport who are there just to welcome and put students in taxi or airport transfer.
How many students are currently here?
We have, I think at the moment, this week, 86 students, which is pretty much as full as we can be. And okay. I think it's quite a nice atmosphere, still being quite familial, so have a kind of family atmosphere. And still lots of students that you can form friendships with.
How many people works here?
During summer, we have probably about 30 people who work here. In academic year, we have another probably 40 different staff who come here as well.
Hello. I have some questions to ask okay. to you. How do you look after the students?
So I'm the director of studies, so my main job is to make sure the students are happy with their classes. So on the first day I always ask them how their classes are going, and if they're unhappy I help them and I move them to different classes. Also in the houses I make sure everyone's feeling okay, everyone's eating well, basically like their parents.
How do you still keep in shape, because you wake up before us and mm-hmm. you go to bed after?
So I wake up every day at 4 o'clock, and then I go running every morning at 4, and then I go to the gym at 5. So I do all of my exercise before anyone wakes up, which means in the daytime I have lots of time to work. But yeah, I do my exercise early in the morning. I love the mornings here.
Okay, it's really impressive.
Thank you.
What do you do when we are in class?
When you're in class, I do a little bit of work on my laptop. So I write the timetables for the coming weeks. I make materials for the teachers. Sometimes I go to the park and lay in the sun if I want to relax, and I have coffee. So it's quite nice. It's quite quiet as well.
Who chooses the excursions and the activities?
So the excursions are chosen before the summer. They're usually organised by Sarah. And the activities, all of the activity department, we talk and we discuss in the morning, and then we choose them usually on the day. So it's a mixture of the whole team.
Okay.
Thank you.
When is the food prepared?
It's fresh every morning. So deliveries come in between 9 o'clock in the morning, from 7 till 9, and then we start prepping straight away. If we have leftover food, we will use it to make something new the next day, but if it doesn't get eaten, it will go in the bin. Or anything left over and we have too much of, we actually ring somebody who gives it to the local homeless people, so they come and collect it. If it's edible, then they come and collect it.
So you cook in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, in the main building, everything. Cakes, main meals, desserts, everything. Everything in there.
Okay. Do you make special food, like vegetarian or...?
Yeah, okay, we have vegan and vegetarians. Or if we have special dietary requirements, like if they've got peanut allergies, then we cook them something different. Depending on each person. Whenever someone starts the school, we ask about them and their dietary requirements and what they need. We do have a list with pictures of each student in the kitchen as well, so we know who doesn't eat what. because with a school with so many students, there's always someone like seafood allergy or peanut allergy. So yeah, we have vegan, vegetarian and allergies on the board, so we know.